wanted to start out this evening with a special prayer in Sanskrit. Actually, usually we begin always with an invocation, but this particular prayer is one that some of us, that are particularly those of us staying in the Bhakti Center, we sing every morning. Sang this morning, we get up very early. It's a prayer to the spiritual teacher, to the guru. This Sanskrit word guru means heavy. Heavy in what context? The guru is said to be like a cloud that is heavy with rain. They're heavy with knowledge, heavy with grace, heavy with blessings. And that cloud, today's a good day for a cloud analogy. I'm feeling very at home as well with the climate today. So this life, in this first verse of this prayer, says samsara davanala. Davanala means a forest fire, that this life that we're in, even though we have so many good days and, you know, wonderful moments, but there's some burning aspect to it, burning quality. There's many things that push and pull us and make us question what actually is this? Why am I here? When those questions are left unanswered, it can be very, very uncomfortable, to say the least. So it's said that this life can be blazing like a forest fire. Has anyone ever seen a forest fire or been in a forest fire? So it's not really the coast for it. If you're on the west coast, it's pretty common. Last summer, I was in British Columbia in Canada, and I've never seen a forest fire, but last year was the worst forest fires in many decades. And actually, I had no idea this was happening, and I had to travel into the Rocky Mountains a little bit, actually into where the fire was happening. And I was staying there for a few days, and every day you would wake up and it was just like white in front of, to where you're sitting. I couldn't see further than that. It was the density of the smoke. And every day they were saying, okay, maybe the fire's blowing this way or it's blowing that way. But it was out of control. There was nothing that could be done. So in these situations, the forest fire needs to be put out by water, so that spiritual teacher, that guru, is said to be like a cloud that comes in and descends. That, you know, a cloud, if it dropped all of its water all in one moment, it could knock somebody down, it could kill somebody, but it rains down in this certain way, so much grace, and alleviates that burning. So there are many other verses in this prayer, but if I could invite you to close your eyes for a moment. And before we begin, just bring into your mind somebody that has, if you have a guru or a teacher, please bring them into your mind's eye. Or somebody that you really wish to offer gratitude to. All of us have been helped in different ways in life. We're going to sing together these few words, Vande. You can say it together, Vande.
Vande.
Guru Shri.
Guru Shri.
Charanaravindam.
Charanaravindam.
Vande Guru Shri.
Vande Guru Shri.
Charanaravindam.
Charanaravindam.
This means I offer my heartfelt respects and I bow down before the feet of the Guru, which are compared to a lotus flower. So beautiful, so cooling, so brilliant. Vande Guru Shri Charanam. As we're singing this Vande Guru Sri Charanaravindam, I'm thinking also how special it is, this aspiration that Joe is expressing to make New York one big kirtan. Maybe many of you know the story of a great saint, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Actually, I think his picture is here on the altar. Many years ago, about 51 years ago, about 50 years ago, he came to New York City from India on a cargo ship across the Atlantic Ocean. And his desire was to, just what you expressed, make New York, not only New York, but the whole world, one big kirtan. And where we stay at the Bhakti Center in the East Village, close by is Tompkins Square Park, where he started a kirtan by himself under a tree. And people started to gather. Young people especially were interested. Who is this man wearing saffron robes who's just appeared out of nowhere in the East Village? And because of that courageous act, we are all sitting here today, at least all of us. So we're offering that prayer, Vande Guru Sri Charanaravindam. That's one of the greatest gifts that the teacher, the guru, brings, is the mantra. Because the mantra gives a goal. The mantra gives sustenance to the heart. That sacred sound vibration, it has the power to change everything inside and out. So the guru gives that mantra. So we'll sing that mantra later on, the one that he gave. But the next mantra that we'll sing also kind of relates to this story of a teacher coming at an opportune moment. So when Bhaktivedanta Swami came to New York, some people say it was like a window, it was just the right time. It was like the hippie movement, actually not quite the hippie movement, but this counterculture rising, and people were really questioning the meaning of what their parents had told them were the values that they should have, the goals that they should have. So they were attracted to something different, and this happened at just the right time for something to catch a light. So this next mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. It was taught to a very young boy many, many thousands of years ago. His name was Dhruva Maharaj. He had been offended very, very badly by his own father and his one of his mothers. He had another mother, the king. His father was the king who had more than one wife, as kings in that time was very common. And he'd been very sorely rejected by his father and insulted by this other queen. And he was only 5 years old. He was deeply, deeply hurt by this. And when he ran to his mother, she said, well, the only thing you can do to alleviate this situation, to reach whatever goal you might desire to attain, is to worship the Lord. Go into the forest. He took that very seriously, and he went when he was just a little boy into the forest, and he started to perform these great penances, austerities, standing on one toe. Even yogis today can't attempt standing on one toe, eventually breathing only once a week. The air was his food. And he was creating such a fire by his austerity that the whole world, he started to hold his breath, and the whole world became suffocated. So the heavenly beings, the devas, they said, somebody has to go tell him to stop. We can't breathe. Somebody go and tell him. So none of them wanted to, none of them wanted to go. But a great sage named Narad, he was willing. And he went to him and he said, oh, what are you trying to do here? You're doing some very difficult penances. So when he explained to him, he said, well, you're doing wonderful things, but actually there's something else that you should be doing. You should be reciting the mantra. And he gave him this mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. He said, just chant this mantra and everything that you desire will become fulfilled. So we'll finish the story later, but first let's chant a little bit together.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate
Respectful obeisance to Bhagavan, that supreme person who has all beauty, all fame, all intelligence, all strength, all knowledge, all renunciation, who's known as Vasudev. And something very wonderful happened to him. He had his eyes closed, and within his heart, he had the most amazing divine vision of that Supreme Person shining brilliantly, wearing golden ornaments and a yellow silk cloth, with eyes like lotus petals, and he was gently smiling. And Dhruva was just amazed. He was in that inner space, taking that darshan or that vision, and suddenly he disappeared. And he opened his eyes looking, and that same Supreme Person, Sri Vishnu, Vasudev, was standing in front of him. And he completely lost all his words. He'd had this burning desire in his heart for so long.
All of us know what it feels like to have a burning desire, something that we really, really want. In that moment, he completely forgot what he had desired, and he was just completely stunned. He was calling. He wanted to offer a prayer, but he had no words. So that Supreme Person touched him on his head, and he gave him the power to offer words of praise. He said, "My Lord, now that I see you, I realize that I wanted to become the greatest king that ever lived. I wanted to have an amazing kingdom. But now I realize that this desire that I had is just like a broken piece of glass, because the real diamond, the real jewel is standing here before me." And he offered these prayers, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So mantra, connection with that Supreme Person, has the power to realign our goals, our direction in life. We chant really sincerely from the heart. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya. Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya. Vasudevaya.
Call out these names, Vasudev, Govinda, Krishna. We're trying to call them out with a lot of love. And it means a lot when someone calls out your name with love, right? When you hear somebody say, Laura. We can do it now. Let's say Joe's name with a lot of love. We can call it out to him. Joe! One more time. A little bit more.
Joe!
How does it feel?
Feels good.
It's the best feeling when somebody calls out your name with love in their heart. So we're trying to do that with these sacred names. We're not just calling out sounds. We're trying to call to that Supreme Person. And we've been talking sometimes about how in the kind of urban environment can pull us away from that personal feeling of having, it's like that, anyone used to watch Cheers? That thing in the theme song, you wanna go where everyone knows your name, right? You wanna, that feeling of home is where everyone knows my name. And when I come in the door, they call it with so much love. The Bhakti Center is like that. Anyone that walks in the reception door, you know, everyone will get spring, give you a big hug. But Jaya wrote a beautiful poem about his experience of, anyway, you can tell.
She wants me to do this. So please forgive me if it's not perfect. I'm from Chicago. So Chicago compared to New York is like a suburb. And my experience in the city of New York is somewhat a deeply impersonal one. And oftentimes being in New York, one of the things that I was often confronted with was a lot of the homeless people in the street. And I felt very confronted by that, almost like I was having an existential crisis with how to respond to them. Does anyone ever get that experience? Yes, a little. And so what I realized is that because I didn't know them, I couldn't have any goodwill toward them oftentimes because I couldn't put a face to, I couldn't put a name to their face. And so it was very easy to treat them impersonally. And then I realized walking, one time I was at Rockefeller Center with some friends and it's just like so many people there. Literally you just like walk into the thing and just like this, moving around. So I realized it was like a sea of nameless faces. And because of that sea of nameless faces, I'm not able to wish people well because I'm not knowing them. And so how nice it is when you can put a name to a face, and a face to a life, and a life to a relationship, and then you have exchanges like that. And I realize in the cities, it's not so easy to do that. Even meeting up with friends is very difficult. We have to like go around our schedules, okay, are you
apart
free?
Apart from things like this.
Huh?
Apart from things,
apart
like,
from things like this. You have to meet up, okay, can I meet you? How about next year? Yeah. You got time next year? Yeah, I may have time next year. So I, and also with a lot of my friends, I see many of, one lives in Bushwick, another one lives in Upper East Side, another Upper West Side. And so we're quite isolated from each other. So I kind of wrote a poem to articulate a little bit of my experience like that. But I was supposed to commit it to memory. I kind of have it committed to memory, but not perfect. So that's why my iPhone is sitting here, if it doesn't look too spiritual. And you're wondering why this non-spiritual object is in front of me like this. I'm not checking my Instagram. So I'm gonna put my little hat on and try to get in my little cipher space here.
We're gonna need your help after also with the little
clicks, little snaps. So this piece, I call it Nameless Faces to describe the impersonal experience that I'm having here or have had here in the city and hope to change through relationships. So please hear it and give me your well wishes. Just a sea of nameless faces occupying city spaces, racing after lifeless objects with the hope that it replaces the embraces that the seraphim would offer to their nations in the form of words and chasing hearts with hope of better places. The better me eclipsed by impersonal calamity, inanity marks the ethos in the quest of vanity. Integrity dismissed as we blunderbuss garrulities, buffoonery rewarded with a TV show for all to see. In the sea of nameless faces, what's he face is probity. In the name of speak your truth, we're lost to moral sanity. Empty words proclaiming unity and diversity. But I can't tell if next to me is a friend or enemy. In the sea of nameless faces, homeless men and women weep in vanity. For many are lost to their humanity. Spending $80 for one meal, I have no problem. But they ask me for some change and know that I'm prepared to bottle. The debacle is my pretense of concern for my kith and kin. All the way across the ocean, I demand we must defend. As I virtue signal on my Instagram, now please come in. Oh, my neighbor died? Anyway, what's his name again? Just a sea of nameless faces occupying city spaces. Racing after lifeless objects with the hope that it replaces the embraces that the seraphim would offer to their nations in the form of words and chasing hearts with hope of better places. Govinda Jaya Jaya, Gopala Jaya Jaya, Govinda Jaya. Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya
Govinda
Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radharamana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Krishna, Hare Hare.
sing together. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare.
Beautiful name, Govinda. Govinda means that one who attracts the senses, all of the senses. In the city, we're constantly under attack. There's advertisements everywhere. There's sirens, there's voices, there's color, there's smells. Everything is pulling on our senses at all times. Sometimes we're pulled this way towards something attractive, sometimes towards something that we don't really want to look at, but we can't help it. That smell is just so bad, you just turn your face. Govinda is the one that we really want to attract all of the senses, because when all of the senses are completely tied to Govinda, then the heart becomes completely peaceful, completely satisfied, and filled with ananda, with joy. So let's call out this name together, Govinda, and pray that we can all be tied to that supreme personality, Shri Krishna, day and night, 24/7, till all of New York becomes one big kirtan.
Govinda, Govinda, Govinda.
Keshava, this is Keshava. See, I should introduce everyone, I completely forgot. This is Yusuf on the guitar. Guitar and bass together. Kishore Gopal. Jaya Jagannath on the poetry. And Keshava and Vasudev. And over there is Govinda. Their brother Govinda. They come together in a three. So Keshava is going to lead us in one last kirtan. We save the best till the last.
Thank you. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Krishna, Krishna, Krishna.